Hello dear friends, welcome back once again to our channel Vage Academy of Mathematics. We have successfully completed three parts from alphanumeric series. Previous year's questions we have solved. Part 1, 2, 3 we completed. We saw some few problems there in those previous sessions. And here this is part 4 and this is going to be the last part. By this session, we are completing all problems from alphanumeric series from previous year's questions. So yes, we'll directly get into the questions. So our first question here for this session is, this question is from the year 2016, July month. I will number this question, question number one. Yes, and we'll see the question. In the given series, find the missing term. So this question is appearing to be a little strange than what we have done earlier. But again, it's not going to be that hard at all. We'll carefully analyze what is given in the question and then get the answer, fine? Yes. So let's see the series here. AB, then EDC, then FGHI. Then there in between one term is missing and they have given the next term, OPQRST. That's it, very simple. The question appears to be very simple. Let's just as simply try to get the answer, fine? First of all, we'll try to understand how they are building the terms here. See, the first term we have AB, two letters. Second term, the next term, we have three letters. Then again, the next term, we have four letters. And in between, one term is missing. And the next term, I mean the fifth term, we have how many? Six letters. See, this is the way they are building the sequence, is it or not? So two letters here, three letters here, four letters here, and then some term is missing, and then six letters here. So this is how we are having the sequence. So that means from here itself, we can clearly understand the missing term must have how many letters? We must have five letters. Is the point clear? Why? Because see here, two letters, three letters, four letters, then we must have the missing letters, missing term with five letters. Then we have the next one with six letters. So this is how the sequence is built. So with this itself, we can understand we must have five letters for the answer. And now we will analyze what letters we have here in this sequence. So the first term we have AB. Yes. And come to the second term. Second term we have EDC. That is, if you carefully see this, it's very easy for us to understand. We have AB, the first two letters, and the second term is having the next three letters of the alphabets. So after AB, we'll be having the next three letters to be CDE. Is it or not? That CDE is what is present here in the reverse order. Very simple. Is the point clear? So first term, we have AB, and second term, we have the next three letters, just the next three letters. CDE, but they are given in the reverse order. You can analyze it. You can just observe it. Very easy to see here. EDC, right? And again, come to the next term. We have four letters. What are the next four letters after E? What are the next four letters? We'll be having FGHI. You can come see this tables here. So we have AB and then we have CDE, but this is given in the reverse order. This is what we have in the reverse order. And next we have the next four letters. I will just take the next four letters, F, G, H, I. And that F, G, H, I is present in the straight order only. Okay. And what should come next? We must have the next five letters, right? Yeah, next five letters should come. But hold on, come skip the next one. Skipping to the next one, we have the next six letters. See here, O, P, Q, R, S, T. This is what we have. And they are again in the straight order. So that means they have taken the first term in the straight order, second term in the reverse order. Again, third term in the straight order. Now come to the fourth term. That fourth term should have their letters in the reverse order. Very simple, right? So that means here it is very simple for us to conclude and get the answer as we must have the next five letters coming here and particularly they must be present in the reverse order. Very simple, that's it. Now come back to the tables here, alphabets. So what are the next five letters we have? The next five letters are J, K, L, M, and N. these are going to be the next five letters. Is it or not? But as told, these letters should be written in the reverse order. Why do you understand this? Because the first term we have straight, second one we have in the reverse order, third term we have straight order, then this fourth term, missing term, we must have in the reverse order. Again, see this fifth term, we have it in the straight order. So that means they are giving it in the alternate way, straight order, reverse order, straight order, reverse order. This way they are just framing the sequence, and in that way we must have our five letters. Which five letters? Yeah, come here, J, K, L, M, N. We must have them in the reverse order. So if I write them in the exact reverse order, what will we get? We will have N first, then we will have M, then L, then K, then J. I think you are able to understand, because the straight order will be J, K, L, M, N. Now if we write in the exact reverse order, we'll be having N, M, L, K, J. That's it. And which is matching with option 3. Is it or not? Yeah, option 3 is what is exactly matching our answer. N, M, L, K, J. And see the fourth option. Fourth option is more near, but we have a bit collapse there. N, M, K, L, J, like that we have. So it is just a trap answer. Just to confuse us, they have included this option. But the correct answer, if you properly see that, our answer has to be N, M, L, K, J. Is it or not? N, M, L, K, J, which is exactly option 3. Simple. That's it, right? Yeah. Now I think we can move on to the next question. Yeah, question number 2. Now this question number 2 is from November 2017. It is from the year 2017, November month. I'm marking it to be question number 2. And let's see this question. Find the next term of the given series. This is our question. Yeah. So let me take the terms here. I will take the terms. Yes. So we have the terms as A, B, D, as usual. Like how we used to write these kind of terms, we write them one below the other, right? The same way I'm writing them here. A, B, D. Then the next term we have D, G, K. Yeah, fine. And what next we have? We have H, M, S. We have this. And then what next we have? We have, yeah, come here. Next we have M, T, B, right? Yeah, we have M, T, B. I'm writing it here, M, T, B. And what is the next term? That is our question. And of course, each term, we have three letters. So that means our answer must also have three letters. And what three letters should come? That is our question. And as usual, like this pattern of question, whenever is asked, we just try to observe the pattern for each of these letters. Is it or not? Yes, the same way. Now also we are going to proceed. Start from the first letter of each of these terms. The first letter here for the first term, the first letter is A. So from A to D, we will just see what pattern they have done here, how they have traveled. So A is the first letter, D is the fourth letter. That means first to fourth, they are moving, which would be plus 3, right? 1 to 4, they are moving. That means they have done 3 positions in the forward direction. So 1 to 4 will be plus 3. Continue. Next, they are moving D to H. Yeah, come here. Now, if you see, D is at the fourth position and H is at the eighth position. Is it or not? Yes. So D is 4 and H is 8. So 4 to 8 this time they are moving. So that means 4 to 8 will be plus 4 here. Is it or not? Do the calculations properly, carefully. That is really important. Yeah. Next, they are moving from H to M. Yeah, H to M they are going. So H is at the 8th position and M is at the 13th position. So 8 to 13 they are moving. So 8 to 13 will be actually plus 5. Is it or not? Because 8 plus 5 will only give us 13. So that means H to M they are moving 5 positions in the forward direction. So yeah. This is giving us a proper pattern. I think with this itself, we can find the first letter of this missing term. Is it or not? See the pattern, what pattern they are following? Plus 3, plus 4, plus 5. The gap is gradually increasing, right? For the first letters. One by one, it is increasing. Plus 3, plus 4, plus 5. That means from M, what we need to do here? Plus 3, plus 4, plus 5. That means we must do plus 6 here. Is it or not? That will complete the pattern. Is it or not? Yes. So that means in order to find this first letter, we have to do M plus 6. Let's carefully do that. See here, M is already at the 13th position, right? M is 13. From 13, we need to do that plus 6. So do carefully, what is 13 plus 6? 13 plus 6 will be actually 19. Is it or not? 13 plus 6 will be 19. So 19 corresponds to which option actually here? 19 corresponds to S. Is it or not? Yes. I'm feeling it to be S. So this completes the first letter. And as usual, what next we have to do? Don't go for the second term. Now directly come to the options. Options and then see which option is matching our answer. First letter should be S. So we are very fortunate. There's only one option matching with the first letter is S. That means option 2. So that means we can confirm that option 2 is our correct answer. So this looks very easy, right? Yeah. So this is the reason we are moving piece by piece. Okay. So very simply, just by making the operations for one letter itself, we are able to get the answer correctly. So which is option 2. So that means our correct answer is option 2, which is SBL, right? Anyways, if you need practice, we can still do. Just for one more term, we can try it and do. Okay. Just for confirmation, we'll just try to do just one more term. We will do. Okay. And I will again remind you, please do not do this in your exam. Since this is our session, we can even take any number, much time. We can even take more time to solve a single question. This is not at all a problem at all, right? So here, while you do your practice, when you're under practice, you can take any time. You can take much time also. There's nothing wrong. In learning, while learning, you can take more time. But when you are appearing the exam, it is not the thing that you should not waste your time. Even a single second matters. Each and every second matters. That's why, okay. So just for practice, I'm just showing you the second letter. We'll try to see what pattern is followed in the second letter. We'll just do it for the second letter and see what happens. So yes, second letter is B. So B to this one, G they are moving. So B to G, come to the table. In table, if you see, B is at the second position. And G, if you see, where is G? G is at the seventh position. Is it or not? Yeah. So B is second and G is seventh. So that means 2 to 7 they are moving. 2 to 7 is plus 5. So the first jump itself they have done plus 5. Anyways, we will continue this. Yeah. Next, what we need to do is we need to do G to M. So G to M, let's see what happens. So G is at the seventh position and M is at the 13th position. Is it or not? So from 7, they are moving on to 13. So 7 to 13 will be how many positions forward? Just think 7 plus what number will give us 13? 7 plus 6 we have to do. Is it or not? So that means plus 6 they are moving here. See, G is at 7 and M is at 13. So 7 to 13 they are moving. So they are doing plus 6 here. Yeah, continue. Next, they are going from M to T, they are moving, right? Yeah, come here, continue. M to T, they are moving. So M is 13, is it or not? M is 13. And what about T? T is at the 20th position. Do you see this? See, T is at the 20th position, right? Yeah, here it is. So that means here they are moving from 13 to 20. So 13 to 20 is actually how many steps forward? How many positions forward? 13 to 20 is actually plus 7. Is it or not? 13 plus 7 will only give us 20, right? Yeah. Yes. So that means, see, for the second letter, what pattern is followed here? Here they are doing plus 5, plus 6, plus 7. Like this, it is going on for the second term. Second letter, right? Yeah. That means in order to get the missing second letter, what should be done? See, for the first one, what pattern is followed? Plus 3, plus 4, plus 5. So as a continuation, we did plus 6 here. Now come here for the second term, second letter, what is happening? plus 5 plus 6 plus 7. It is going like this. So that means what next we have to do? Here we need to do plus 8. Is it or not? Yeah, plus 8 we need to do. That is, come back to T. T is at the which position? T is at the 20th position. So that means from 20, we need to do plus 8. Is it or not? So just do 20 plus 8. What happens? What is 20 plus 8? 20 plus 8 will be 28. You may wonder, alphabet stops with 26 itself. Is it or not? We only have up to 26 letters, but we are getting 20 plus 8 is 28. So for this is what we need to see, the extended numbers. You have already seen, right? So this is the reason we have the numbers in the right hand side also. Continue. See here, from 1 to 26 we have from A to Z, and after, again, if we continue numbering the alphabets, we will again start with A as 27, B as 28, C as 29, and so on. This goes like this. So for this purpose only, I am just showing you this second letter pattern. Okay, yeah, fine. So that means 20 plus 8 is giving us 28. Now we need to see 28 as the right hand side. See here, 28 corresponds to which letter here? It corresponds to the letter C here. Yeah, it is here, right? 28 corresponds to the letter B. That means here, as the 28th position, we will be having B. Yeah, fine. I think this is clear to you. And this is still confirming our answer. SBL is the correct answer, right? Yeah, I think this is clear to you. And also, just remember this. Exactly to show this purposely, I just included and I just made this practice. Okay, I just showed this working way. So what happens when our counting is going to exceed the 26? So what we need to do? Again, continue numbering from A as 27, B 28, C 29, and go and so on. That's it. Okay. Yes. That's all. Yeah. Move on to the next question. What is the next question we will see? So this is the last question we have for this session. So we'll see the question. What is the question? So this question is question number 3, which is from 2018 July month. And the question is asking ABD, DGK, HMS, MTB, SBL, and what next? This is our question. And if you just see, this is nothing, none other than what we just worked out, the second question. Is it or not? See the questions, both the questions are same, right? ABD, DGK, HMS, MTB, and SBL, what next is our question. See our previous question, what we worked just now. So the questions are same, but the only thing is, here in our third question, they are just asking SBL, up to SBL they have given, and what next will come? They're just asking what is the next term. So if you see all the other, the letters, the terms, everything, they're all the same. But here they are just asking what will be the next term that will come even after this SBL. That's all they're asking. I think we need not work from the beginning. We'll just continue this second question itself and then get the answer. Is that fine? Right? Because we have the same question only, right? ABD, DGK, HMS, MTB, everything is same. See, the same terms are what? Here also we have repeated here. See, ABD, DGK, HMS, everything is the same, correct? MTB and SBL also they gave. Yeah, SBL also they gave. See this one? They gave till this SBL. Till this SBL we have. And all they are asking is, what will be the next term? So up to SBL it is there. After SBL what comes? So that means, we need to continue the second question. That's it. So what we will do is, we'll not work from the beginning. We will just try the very next term of this SBL. That will give the answer to the third question. Simple, right? Yeah. So that means what we need to do is, we need to continue the pattern. And one more thing what we have to do is, we will also have to get the complete answer, we should also try to do what? We should also try to find the pattern for the third letter also. Is it or not? See here, for the third letter, we didn't build the pattern here. We didn't build the pattern. For the third letter also, we need to do the pattern. But anyways, for the first two, we have the pattern, right? Let us complete the first two letters of the answer. Do you understand this? See here, for the first two letters only, we completed and we have the pattern. Let us complete the first two letters here. Fine. Yes. Let's continue the first letter here. So we did plus 3, plus 4, plus 5, plus 6 is okay. So that means what should come next? We must have plus 7 here. So what will be S plus 7? Come to the table. Come to the table here. Table, we have S to be 19. Is it or not? S is at the 19th position. So from 19, we need to do plus 7. Is it or not? So what is 19 plus 7? 19 plus 7 will give us exactly 26. And 26 corresponds to the letter, the last letter, which is Z. I'm just placing the Z here. And we will see whether this will help us to eliminate any options or get the correct answer. Yeah, we are a little fortunate here. See, we can actually eliminate options. The options 1 and 4. Sorry, option 1 only we can eliminate. I'm very sorry. Option 1 alone we can eliminate, because we have all the other remaining 3 options. We have only starting with Z. Is it or not? Yeah. Yeah, fine. Anyways, we will continue. We'll try to form the pattern for the second letter. Shall we? Yes, continue the second letter. And we'll try to get the pattern for the second letter. Second letter, we have plus 5, plus 6, plus 7, plus 8. And what should come next? So we should do B. From here, we need to do plus 9. Because we have here for the second letter, the pattern is plus 5, plus 6, plus 7, plus 8. So that means as a continuation, we must do plus 9 here. Is it or not? So just do B plus 9. So B is already at what position? See, B is at the 28th position. Now, no matter. We can even consider this B as the second position. No problem at all. Okay. Fine. Because we have started the cycle once again. That's why. So B, we will take it even to be 2. Now from 2, we'll have to just do plus 9. What is 2 plus 9? 2 plus 9 will give us 11. Is it or not? 2 plus 9 will give us 11. And 11 corresponds to the letter K. I will fill this K here. Is the point okay? See, you may ask, you may have a doubt like B we already considered to be 28. Then why can't we do 28 plus that 9? You can even do that. No problem at all. You can even do 28 plus 9. See what happens to 28 plus 9. So 28 plus 9 will give us 37, right? Even 37 will correspond to the same letter K. So it doesn't matter in what way you are doing it. Okay. Do it in the way where you will get the answer more easily. That is what matters. Right? Yeah. However, the second letter, we got it to be K. Again, we'll come back to the options, whether any options is matching our answer. So first letter is Z, second letter is K. So first letter is Z, with that we are able to eliminate only one option. And second letter says it is K. So that means now we can eliminate one more option also. Correct? Option 3 we can eliminate. See here, option 3, the second letter is C. But option 2 and option 4, both of them are having the second letters to be K. Is it or not? So that means we are still left with 2 more options. That means we are in a situation that we must try the third letter also. No other way. We must try the third letter, trace the pattern, and then only we'll be able to get the correct answer for the third question. So that means we have a task. Let me do a thing. We'll have to begin from the first term. We have to start. Okay, I'm erasing these tick marks. Yes. I think we have to start from the beginning. Yes, no matter. We'll just try. So start for the third letter. Try to get the pattern. Because only if we try to get the pattern, we'll be able to find what letter comes after this L. Is it or not? Yeah, fine. So start from this D. So D to K, they are moving. So D to K will be fourth position. D is at the fourth position and K is at the seventh position. Is it or not? So 4 to 11. Sorry, K is at the 11th position, right? Yeah. So D is 4 and K is 11. So that means here they are moving plus 7 positions. I think you are able to understand this. See, D is at the 4th position. And then K is at the 11th position. So from 4 to 11 is plus 7 only, correct? That's what I've written here. Continue. Next, they are going for K to S. Come to the table again. So K is at the 11th position and S is at the 19th position. See here, S is at the 19th position. So that means, so 11 to 19 they are moving. So 11 to 19 is actually plus 8. Yeah, fine, continue. Next is S to B, they are moving. So S is again 19th position, and B is where B is at the second position. Or if we travel in the forward direction, we may have to exceed the number count more than 26. So that means C, this B is 28th position. Do you understand? Because now I am traveling from S to B. Is it or not? Now if we go for the forward direction, what happens is after 26, I may need to count more. So for that, what we can do? We'll just take this B's position as the right hand side number, that is 28. Okay, is the point clear? So that means from S to B they are moving. So that means S to B will be nothing but 19 to 28. Tell what is 19 to 28? So 19 plus what number will give us 28? It is easy for us to say 19 plus 9 will only give us 28. So that means from S to B they are moving plus 9. Again, continue from B to L we have to go for. So from B, again, we are now at B. Let me do a thing. I will just erase the previous arrow marks so that it may not confuse us. That's why. Okay. Yeah, I'm erasing these arrow marks. Yeah, come. Firstly, I'm just making an arrow mark here. So B to L, they are moving. See, up to B, we have already reached. Now from B to L, they are going. So L is at the 12th position. So that means they are now traveling from this 28th to 38th position. This way we can have, or even otherwise we can have it like the same, the original left hand side itself, 2 to 12 they are moving, no matter. Okay, see, for this forward direction is what I just considered the right hand side numbers. Now we are within the count only, so we can even take it as 28 to 38. I mean, this B to L we can consider as either 28 to 38, or to make it simple, we can even consider as 2 to 12. Now we are on the same side, that's why. Okay, so 2 to 12, we are on the same cycle. We need not exceed the count. So that's why I'm just taking 2 to 12 itself. Okay, so 2 to 12, you see how many positions it is moving forward. So 2 to 12, very simple to say, 2 plus 10 only will give us 12. So that means from B to L, they are moving plus 10. That means one more we have to do. So from L to the next term, we have to move, right? So L is at what position? L is at the 12th position. From here, how many positions we have to move? So see the pattern formed here, plus 7, plus 8, plus 9, plus 10. So that means what next should come? Plus 11 should come. That means L plus 11. 12 plus 11 we have to go. L is already at 12. And from 12, we have to move 11 positions in the forward direction. So 12 plus 11 will give us how much? 12 plus 11 will be 23. Is it or not? 12 plus 11 will be 23, right? You can even add and see. 12 plus 11 will be 23. And 23 corresponds to which letter? It corresponds to W. And that means we are successfully getting the third letter also. Now we can confirm which option is the correct answer. ZKW. That means option 4 is matching our answer. Is it or not? See here, option 4 is matching ZKW. That means this is going to be the correct answer for our question. So this third question made us to spend more time actually, because we had a necessity to form the pattern for the third letter also. So that is the reason we took some extra time. But again, to explain it more detail, I just went slowly. When you are making a good practice, these calculations will not seem to take much time for you at all. All these are simple numbers, right? We know how to add. 8 plus 5 is 13. 7 plus 9 is 16. Everything we know, right? So just a practice is more needed. So once this practice is done, we can very, very easily finish these questions. Okay, fine. So yeah, we have successfully completed the fourth part of alphanumeric series also. And by this, alphanumeric series is also ending. And from our next session, we'll have to take other topic and we'll take some set of questions and try those questions there from previous years. See you soon there. Thank you so much. Bye.